Hi guys, I thought I would do, welcome to my laundry, I thought I would do a video of one of the Simpson fluid drives in action, one that I've actually been working on, and pretty much I thought I'd just do a load, you can sort of see it working. These are the fully programmed, this is a fully programmed 1971 model, has the plastic liner tub, or what Simpson called was the flexible channel rib liner. So, without further ado, I will light it up, and okay, so here's the control panel. So we've got buttons on all this side, we've got the time indicator in the middle, and the programs on the other side. So I'm pretty much going to do just a load of basic colours, just some shirts that I do not really wear anymore pretty much, so now the beauty of these machines, or the most interesting part, is that the difference between, and you'll see it once it starts filling and actually transfers, is that the difference between these fluid drives and, say, the American Speed Queens, or the Speed Queens in America and Canada, is that these actually fill to the outer tub first, and then they transfer to the inner tub, because they have if you see here, they've got a recirculating lint filter, which I've actually put on an extra to catch any further lint out of that. Now, while I actually think the flexible channel tub is a great idea, what Simpson never really explained to people was just how filthy the actual sort of like lint when it catches on the outer tub. Okay, so what we've got is going to do a non-colour fast. Now there is a little light here as well, however I'm actually using another light here to try and get a bit more light into the garage for the video. Okay, so we'll do a full load obviously, and as you'll see, once we actually start clicking over to the program start, okay, so as you hear, it's actually filling to the outer tub first, and then in a couple of minutes you'll see it transfer to the inner tub. If you'll see over in the corner here, there is a little test hole that you could actually test to sort of see if the water was the right temperature and adjust accordingly. What it does is it has two holes, it actually fills through here and then fills to the other tub, and then it'll actually sort of like transfer over. And these machines do have a recirculating lint filter, so this is actually the actual lint filter here, so this is where it transfers the water to, but it is actually a lint filter as well. Here we go. Any second now? Now you're probably wondering, how can a solid tub possibly have a recirculating wind filter? Well, these Simpsons actually have quite a much wider outer tub, so therefore what happens is that there's a lot more water still in the outer tub, which then needs to be circulated through. Now on the main colour fast cycle, it'll agitate for 11 minutes on the fast and then 3 minutes slow before going into the actual rinse and spin. And if you're wondering about the agitation, it is 202 degrees and 65 oscillations a minute, I think. So this machine here, I actually did take out the inner lining and re-put the new lining in. There's a new agitator shaft in there, although I will need to replace the bushes at some stage as well. Now, if you're wondering about the idea behind the plastic liner, is according to Simpson, it was that any soil or heavy sediment that fell to the tail, rather than was supposed to, because of the grooved bottom of the inner tub, was supposed to disperse behind the liner and out. And although you can't see it with a full load of clothes, you can see it the way that it actually drains with just water in there. So I will do a video of that as well. As you'll see, the length filter is getting quite, my extra length filter over it, they're getting quite full, so I probably will take that off when it goes, after it goes into spin, and actually clean that out. Normally it doesn't have it on there, it's only, normally only got the cartridge filter. Thank you. Okay, so now we go into 3 minutes of the slow wash spin. If you're wondering, spin speed is supposed to be between 600 and 650 RPM. So it'll spin for the last 5 minutes, and then at the when it shuts off, it spins. If you wanted to actually return the sub back into the outer bowl, because it has two outer poses, you automatically have one tub set up, and it automatically primes it for 1 minute after the spinner shut off, and then it'll complete the cycle. So at the moment, it's priming the pump is actually running to prime any suds that you would want back into the outer tub, and then it would refill when you put a new load in. That's it. All done.